Welcome to this Monday Morning Racer on location. I'm Lee Craft, the host. And first, let me state, if you have not been to a race at Summit Motorsports Park, you need to go. It's basically the Disneyland of drag strips. Now, this video will contain footage from the NHRA Summit Racing Equipment Nationals from Friday qualifying for the Nitro classes and also interviews from certain drivers. Hey, hit that like button, subscribe to Monday Morning Racer, and until next time, God bless and keep the pedal to the metal.
Yeah. I set track records, I won races, I did a lot of stuff. I run an alcohol, I run an alcohol funny car, I run fuel funny car, top fuel dragster, I did a lot of stuff. I built my own race cars back in the days. It's a lot going on. Drag racing in Europe is pretty big in sense of, although the Europe is not really big like America, and not a lot of gearheads like here in America, there is still a lot of fan following. That's pretty cool. So for that, the comparison is there, only in Europe it's smaller. That's one of the reasons I want to come here, because if you can race here and win here, you know, that's the highest level possible. Over here it's a professional sport. In Europe it's hard to make it a professional sport. Australia the same, you know, there are a couple of big teams. They have a blast, we have a blast everywhere in the world with drag racing. It's a grassroots sport, right? So for that, it's all cool. I love it because, you know, it's about brute force. You go the 1,000 foot, a quarter mile, and you know everything. You know, if from a tuning point of view, if you did a great job, a good job, driving, it's all in there. So, what was your question?
You've answered it, man. You've answered it, definitely. Now, you said you wanted to come here, race, and win, and you're starting to do that. You're obviously racing. Last week, Bristol, you picked up that first round win against Leah Pritchett.
Yep.
How challenging was driving Bristol as a driver?
Well, the track was really challenging, but the thing, because of the heat, about the bumps, there was a lot going on. The cool thing is that I'm used to that type of situations, because most racetracks in Europe are not that good. They are getting better now. Centerport has a concrete track now. In Sweden there's a concrete track, but when I was running over there, it was asphalt, there was a lot of things going on, and never had a track that was really good. So going into race day in Bristol, I thought, you know what? I recognize a lot of this, and yeah, for sure we lost traction. I know how to pedal a car. I know how to keep it on the ground. It looked maybe a little bit silly, but the only thing, I try to feather the gas because I want to keep the front on the ground, because you cannot cross the center line because you're gone. You're done. You will be disqualified. So I was really happy to see I still got the skills to race those cars. So other than that, yeah, you know, I love the place. It's really, really awesome.
Lex, man, it's cool to see you coming out here living a dream and drag racing. Thank you for being on Monday Morning Racer. We appreciate your time. Good luck.
I appreciate you, and let's keep going. Thank you. And never quit.
Monday morning racer caught up again with Erica Enders. Erica, thank you once again for your time. I'm happy Pro Stock is back out for NHRA National Event because I didn't get to catch them at the Southern Nationals. Tell me, what does it mean for you when Pro Stock is on the premises of a racetrack?
Pro Stock's my jam. Like, that's my bread and butter. I love it. We are coming off of a runner-up finish in Pro Stock. We had a few weeks off and just raced Pro Mod, so I'm really excited to get back in the seat of the Pro Stock car on the heels of that runner-up finish. We're really optimistic coming into this weekend with both cars. I went to the semifinals last weekend in Bristol with the Promont car, and you know what I just said about Chicago and Pro Stock. So I'm excited. I love driving, but I love the clutch and shifting in the Pro Stock car.
So you mentioning, you know, that you've got both classes here this weekend. What are the challenges from going to Pro Stock to Promont, Promont to Pro Stock?
Well, here it's going to be that they run Promont right before Pro Stock. I'm thankful that we have Pro Stock motorcycle here to run in between, because at Richmond it was literally Pro Mod and then Pro Stock. So there's two different kinds of safety equipment required for each car. So in Pro Stock I wear a 15 fire suit, and Pro Mod I wear 20, different shoes, different gloves. So regardless of how quick we have to run, I have to come back to the trailer and change my fire suit to get in the other car. So it's kind of crazy, but I actually honestly like that. Like, I love being busy. I love not having a lot of downtime. I love the pressure, so it makes it fun for me.
So at the Heartland Nationals, Pro Mod round one was absolute carnage. How challenging was it for you? Because I saw an interview with you. You were a bit emotional. How challenging, one, a car being that close to you on the other lane and seeing four other competitors go through what they did. Even though they're competitors, yeah. How tough is that for you?
Well, I mean, I've been driving for 28 years, some form of race car or another, 15 professionally. And in Topeka, that was my closest call, aside from wrecking a Pro Stock car and testing, which whatever. But that was the closest call that I've had, in my professional career. And Jeremy Ray's a blower car, so they leave harder and they're out in front. And with the turbos, we kind of roll the boost in and we come up alongside of him. And as I was coming alongside of him and going around him, I saw out of the corner of my eye his car turn like this. And I'm like, oh my God. Everything happens so fast in those cars anyways. At that point in the racetrack, we were going like 208 miles an hour, I think, at 660, and that's where he got out of shape and started to come into my lane. So there's really not much you can do to save anything. You're just there. So I'm thankful that my angels were working really hard that day and keep keeping him safe as well. He's a really good driver, and him and I talked later in the week about it. You know, he was very apologetic about coming into my lane, but what happened to him can happen to absolutely anybody, and it's kind of the nature of the beast with these cars. They're 4,000 horsepower. It's a suspended race car. It's a short wheelbase, and they're hard. They're hard to drive. So I'm just thankful we were both okay, and it did take a toll on me there for a couple of days. I thought about nothing but that. So because of that incident, I know I'm rambling, but we're taking some extra safety precautions on my car. We've made some changes up to this point, and after this race, there's a 9-week break from Pro Mod because we don't come back until Indy. So my car is going to Rick Jones Chassis Shop to get some extra stuff done to it. I don't care how much it costs. I don't care how much it weighs. If I'm going to drive it, it's happening, and I really hope the rest of the class follows. You know, in NHRA, we have a weight that we have to meet. It's not like outlaw racing, so there's no sense in not being safe to save weight. So anyway, learned a lot from that experience, and you know, hopefully make the class safer and make my race car better for me.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, you know, your team, Elite Motorsports, is saying, hey, we're going to step up on the safety, and I hope NHRA is involved in that as well. Because anything to make it safer for you guys,
yeah.
Because as fans, as people who love racing, we want to see y'all get out of the race car,
yeah,
if something does happen. So on a less serious note, last time I talked to you, you mentioned good company and barbecue, and now we're going into summer. Well, who doesn't love ice cream during the summer? So
yeah,
for a pro mod driver, is it a wild flavor or is it a mild flavor? What's your favorite flavor of ice cream?
Well, you're asking that question at the proper racetrack because you can buy a pound of it here for $1. So my favorite one here is actually Moose Tracks. It's got little bitty peanut butter cups in it. So it's pretty good, like a vanilla base or mint chocolate chip you can never go wrong with. But being from Texas, I'm a Bluebell girl. This ice cream here does not suck. So any ice cream is good ice cream.
Yes, any ice cream is good ice cream. The word from Erica Enders. Erica, thank you for your time.
You're
we
welcome.
Hope you do well this weekend.
Thank you.
Both classes, Pro Mod,
yes,
and Pro Stock.
Fingers
thank you.
Crossed. Thank you.
Sunday morning racer on location here at Norwalk for the Summit Equipment NHRA Nationals. I got Mike Salinas in front of me. Mike, look, first off, let me say, you've been one of the few drivers out here I've noticed. You've hung out kind of all day and haven't been hiding yourself away, so thank you, man. I appreciate that.
Well, everybody pays money to come. So when we come to these races, I work for you guys.
I appreciate that. Thank you. Look, as a father, you've got a daughter on a pro stock bike. You got a daughter in top alcohol. What are your nerves like on a weekend when they're both here and when they're in their race cars? How do you handle it?
Well, I have four kids, and one's going into pro mod, and one's going to go into probably A fuel because the other one's going to move up to top fuel.
Wow.
So all four of them will be running. But you got to have confidence that you taught them right. They know what the limits are. And look, stuff's going to happen out there.
Yep.
So you just talk to the man upstairs. We all got to have a good time. You can't raise them to be strong, confident women and tell them no.
Right.
So they're going to be good. I think we're going to have a great time with the girls. I'm very calm. They're calm. And, look what happened when my daughter dropped the bike over there at the last race. You got to pull yourself together. And I got people depending on us to do it right, you know. So that's what it is.
I think she handled that extremely well. And it was a hard fall. And, in that, I'm curious, I haven't got to talk to her, obviously, but it looked like the wheelie bars kind of came around and hit her in the head.
She got lucky.
Yeah.
Didn't hit her.
Did not hit her.
Did
okay,
not hit
great.
Her.
Good. I was wondering if that had happened, if they had looked at the helmet to see what.
Yeah, we actually, it's got some scratches, but you know what? She got really lucky.
Good.
She got really lucky. Good thing she's small. She had volleyball. She knows how to fall.
All right. Great. Now, look, you've got one of those American dream stories. So in a brief amount of time, could you take me from the humble beginnings where you started to, man, coming out like after 1 week and whipping everybody? How did you get there?
A lot of years of not doing good. And finally, Alan Johnson, the crew, all the guys opened up. And so we brought him on board. I've been stalking Alan for about 7 years. So it finally worked out to my advantage. And he came on board and it worked out real nice. I used to drive nostalgia cars, Bakersfield, California. And Hot Rod Reunion, that kind of stuff. A lot of fun, a lot of great people. And, just want to see what we can do in the sport and have some fun,
Awesome. Mike, look, thank you for being available and being out and talking with the fans. Appreciate that. And look, guys, if you haven't talked with Mike, talk with Mike. You need to be pulling for this man. Go buy a t-shirt, stop by the pits. Mike, thank you for who you are and thanks for being out here.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Monday morning racer here at Norwalk, caught up with Antron Brown. Antron, love, how's it feel to be running good, getting some mojo back?
Man, it feels real good. It feels real good. You know, we, I came out here 2-1, we dropped low ET, and tonight we weren't, I ain't gonna even lie about it. We got a little greedy. He's got a little greedy, and we got two more runs tomorrow, so we go back for that number one spot. That's our goal right now, is just we want to run hard, know that we're there, and we're getting our feet underneath of us to make that run for the championship when the countdown starts after Indy.
All right, so over there on Pro Stock Bike, which you used to run, you won in, some of those cats are running over 200. Any desire to get back on a bike again and hit that mark?
I'll race every class out here. I love pro stock motorcycle. I love pro stock car, pro mod, funny car. I'll race every single one of them. They gave me a vehicle. So the bikes, to see what they're doing now is incredible. And they're doing it at 640 pounds when you race a V-twin. So when you think about 640 pounds, running 200 miles an hour, that's pretty stout. The bikes are making some serious horsepower. They got some serious gains they're showing.
Now, your teammate, Leah Pritchett, a couple of events ago, tricycled one of these top fuelers, and they made some safety changes. I'm curious, did they just do it to her car, or did your car get the treatment as well to help contain some of the parts and pieces from blowing a tire out?
Well, the thing about it was, they had different other problems on the drive line to actually let go, and it caused the car to freewheel when it blew up and took out the rear tire. So, I mean, we're always being proactive on safety on these race vehicles with different things that we have, like the rub locks underneath the race car. You can lower them down, doing different stuff of that nature. And also the main thing is just keeping all the debris away from not taking the tire out is the main issue. So we're always looking at better ways to make this mousetrap to contain the parts and pieces. And we got some more straps, some more harnesses, different things of that nature. And hopefully we can contain it so we don't have instances like that. But the way to stop it is from having part failure. So we just got to keep on making the parts and pieces better so we don't have those issues.
All right, one more question, Antron. You know, things are getting warmer and we're here at Norwalk. Ice cream's a big deal. So for a guy who goes over 300 miles per hour, is it a flavor that's mild or wild? What's your favorite ice cream flavor?
Oh, butter pecan.
Butter pecan.
That is the man's flavor. You get the sweetness, creamy of the butter with the pecan, and you get a waffle cone. Look, I got to go. I want one right now.
Yes. All right, Antron, thank you. This has been Antron Butter Pecan Brown. Take care, man.
I like that.